In this video, you will learn how to render OpenVDB file in Guerilla Render with a 3D motion blur, how to use the noise to add some details in the voxel, what to do with the different volume shader colors, how to use a blackbody model using the voxel temperature, and how to create user top shader in the voxel shader. So first we'll select the OpenVDB file and we drag and drop it into Guerilla like this. And now we'll start the renderer in progressive mode and we'll add a skylight in the project to light the volumetric. Then we'll use the volume shader as a default shader for this project, and we can see now the full cage with the volumetric shader. Now we'll drive the density of the volumetric shader using the voxel density channel like this. So now the voxel has a correct density. Now we'll create an attribute node in the render graph to control different volumetric attributes. First, we'll increase a bit the rematching step size to 5 in order to render faster this volumetric. And then we'll disable the motion blur, the 3D motion blur of the volumetric, to have faster preview. Now we'll add some noise in the voxel density in order to add some details. So first we'll save our current render, and then we'll enable the noise available in the voxel node, like this. Scale, intensity and octaves. And we can see that we have much more details in the voxel density. Let's work now on the volumetric shader color. So first we'll reduce a bit the color attribute to get some darker smoke. And then we'll use the density color to give some different color depending on the scattering of the light inside the volume. So the density color is much more interesting than the color attributes, because the color will change with the depth of the scattering of the light. Now we'll use the blackbody model of this shader. So first we'll enable the blackbody using the blackbody intensity. And so here we can see the whole shader lit with 1000 Kelvin degree. And now we'll drive the blackbody temperature using the actual voxel temperature, and we'll range this temperature to 2000 Kelvin degrees, and we get that. So it's just the voxel temperature applied to the Planck formula, the blackbody formula, which is quite good to start shading. Now we'll do something more custom. We'll use this incandescent input of the shader, and we'll create a subshader for this input. So in this subshader we'll create a voxel node to read the voxel temperature, and this temperature will drive a color gradient. And here we'll do a classical setup for explosion. We'll create a custom user gradient driven by the voxel temperature. So let's work a bit the color gradient. So here we are, we have now a nice explosion. So thank you for watching, I hope you liked it.